Good evening, and thank you all so much for joining us tonight at our Fall Choral and Ringers concert. It has been a busy season already. I cannot believe we're at midterms already this week. But our Chamber Singers has been on fall tour. You'll hear a little bit more about that already. We've already had a play this semester. We've had concerts that are here and there. And so the students are running everywhere, getting to their concerts, getting their formal ready, showing you a taste of what they've been working on all semester. The first piece that we sang to you was God So Loved the World, of course, a familiar text. But one that has been wonderful just to let resonate in our hearts this semester. Faith Port, a sophomore, a music education major, sang the solo on that. And then the second piece was a familiar text as well, a Latin text, Ubi Caritas, where charity and love are, God is there. And so we're going to continue with that theme in this next piece, also on a biblical text, Micah 6:8, a familiar text for many of you, but we've had some friends that are going to join us tonight. So our trusty accompanist, Tara Perry, will be on piano, senior music major, Cam Hume, on sax. We brought an alumni back with us tonight, Tim Schaefer, over there on bass, and singing the solo for us tonight is senior vocal performance major, Micah Lee. So I hope you enjoy this piece, Micah Blues.
Do justice, love kindness, walk humbly with our God, show mercy.
Thank you.
wide variety of music as well. We were excited to get the invitation this year to lead worship for the Missouri Baptist Convention Pastors Conference coming up in a couple weeks, Monday, October 24th. And so this choir before you, our chorale, will get to be heading over to St. Charles, and we're going to be singing about 12 songs of worship, leading pastors from around the state in worship. We're really excited about that. We sing CCM music occasionally as well in our chapel service. And so this next song, we're going to invite you to sing along with us. If you have a program, there's an insert that has some music or some lyrics that you're welcome to join in and sing along with us as we sing. Senior music major Kate Crayon is going to lead us out in the opening solo. So this is My Jesus.
Let me tell you about my Jesus. good evening. I'm Dr. John Francis, and it's a pleasure to be here. I'm the new director of the MBU Ringers, and I'm very honored, especially to follow in the footsteps of their founder, Dr. Kathy Benton, who was their director for over 25 years here. And so we're very, very pleased to play for you too. What you just heard was a bell arrangement of Salvation is Created. And it is a beautiful yet tragic piece written by Pavel Chesnikov. Chesnikov was a composer who absolutely loved Christ, but he was a composer in Russia at a very bad time to be a Christian composer, as he was just coming to his own in composition. That was the moment of the Bolshevik Revolution, and while he taught theory, after that he did not compose any other Christian pieces because they were outlawed. And so that was his final composition that he wrote to Christ. Well, in your bulletin, in your program this evening, you have the list of the ringers, but I also want to introduce to you one of our ringers who is a faculty member, and we're so glad to have him, Mr. Jose Silva. Thank you, Mr. Silva, for ringing with us. He's not just a ringer for the ringers, he's one of the ringers, if that makes any sense whatsoever. So we're glad to have him, and he helps me a great deal. He kind of assists me, especially getting used to the new setup that we have here. The next piece that we're going to play for you is a piece by Gabriel Fauré. And this piece was, self-admittedly by Fauré, a piece that he just kind of tossed off. And it happened to be probably the best known piece he ever wrote. It's called Pavane, which is named after a Renaissance dance. Now it's very slow, and you will probably recall it once you start to hear it. So, without further ado, music of Gabriel Fauré, Pavane.
Thank you.
piece that we're going to do for you. And I don't like to talk between every piece, but we always have to kind of do reset. So I'm just going to preface this piece. First of all, you're going to help us with this piece. I'll get to that in a minute. Actually, my big introduction, I just blew it, but I'll give it to you anyway. So Colin Molloy was this writer, and he once said that a bell is a cup until it's struck. All right, so just take in that big concept. A bell is a cup until it's struck. Well, when we strike bells, we usually strike it with a clapper on the inside. Well, this time we're going to strike the bells only with something on the outside. So you're going to enjoy that. But I need your help. So there is a part where we say Jericho. Now, we can do it, but we're kind of busy. So I'm going to ask you to help me. When I point to you, I need you to say Jericho. So I need you to say it like this. Jericho. Can you do that?
Jericho.
Now, pretty close. Let's try that again. Ready? And.
Jericho.
Okay, now like you mean it this time. Ready?
Jericho.
Perfect. I think you're going to enjoy this. Thank you very much.
There is a meeting here tonight. There is a meeting here.
Then we headed through Illinois and headed up to Indianapolis and got to sing for a private high school up there. They came and visited us last year, and so it was neat to reconnect with them. So we sang for their 5th and 6th grade chapel, and they were the most well-behaved gym full of 5th and 6th graders. I got ready to get up and give a little devotional, and they all pulled out their notebooks. I was like, I'm a professor and a pastor, and that never happens to me. It was awesome. And then we also got to get together with their high schoolers and we sang for them. And then we traveled down and sang at a public high school also while we were there in Indianapolis. Made our way back through, visited with some other alums who are leading worship at First Baptist Church of Bethalto, Illinois, and then closed out our concert across the street over at West Hills. And so the music that you hear tonight, the sacred music, all of it is what we sang. And so as we went to the private schools, of course, they're used to singing sacred music, and the public schools are too, but for us it was a blessing to go into those classrooms and sing God So Loved the World, and to sing Micah 6:8, and just let these scriptures kind of resonate and do their thing as God's word does. That wherever we go and travel, even just as a choir trying to recruit students, we're also going and sharing a message that we hope that God does a great work in those who hear. The first song that you heard, there's a meeting here tonight, an old tune, but spiced up well by the men. It was written for a group called Contus, which you've never heard. It's a wonderful all-male a cappella group that travels and sings. This next piece, I think, will also be a familiar tune for many of you, especially if you like movies or if you have children. you will recognize this tune. But also woven into this tune is a very famous hymn tune called Fairest Lord Jesus, that also comes from kind of that the Norwegian part of the world. And I hope that as you hear it and you hear the lady sing, it will just reflect on your Savior. You reflect on Jesus. Joining us on cajon will be Kate. And then after this, we'll sing another couple pieces for you from chamber singers.
No.
across it this summer as I was picking literature, and it was a groovy tune, right? Like, it's something like, that's cool, that's really fun to sing. And I started looking at it, and when I started looking at the lyrics at first, I was like, do we really want to sing this? Like, is this something that we really want to sing? But of course, there was a little bit of a, to me, with my biblical worldview, some biblical allusion to walking out on the water, right? Taking that step of faith. And so I thought, you know, I want to pick this piece because I want it to be one of those pieces that we talk about and work through. And there's the line that the sopranos sing, everything happened in the way I want, everything's happened in the way I want. And I thought, well, that's weird, because if you're thinking about having faith, walking out on the water, what is that like? But then, on the third time through, they have that one little word that's done in there. Is everything happening the way I want? Is everything happening the way I want? And so we start talking about this idea of, we have this faith, right? As a believer, we're walking through, but then sometimes you get confident and you think, oh, I don't really need him. I don't really need God. I can do this thing on my own. Everything's happening the way I want. And then you have that moment going, well, is everything happening the way I want? And you start to have these moments of questioning and going, wait, I'm trying to live my way. I need to be living God's way. And then it has the line in there about phone stuck, right? Like, he's not answering, what's happening. And so for us, it was a big lesson in, as believers, it's important for us to also engage with secular art. And as believers, looking at that art through a biblical worldview and wrestling with it and talking through it. And how does it, you know, who the original group, when they wrote that song, what are they thinking about when they wrote this? And I'd be curious to have that conversation with them. But for us, with a biblical worldview, looking through it with a biblical lens, we kind of came at it from a different perspective. And so it was a good conversation piece for us this term. The last song that Chamber's going to do for you on their own is a really fun gospel arrangement called My King Is Coming Soon by the same arranger who did Micah 6:8. And then after that, we'll have Chorale come up and join us as we finish off the concert. So this next piece is My King Is Coming Soon. We'll feature Andrew Barton and Will Lonsby.
Yes, he showed up! coming soon. The King is coming, my King is coming soon. The King is coming, my King is coming soon.
The music department becoming NASM accredited, and just so many wonderful things were launching and happening in the life of our university, and we want to celebrate that. We have lots of alums that are out there, and we'd love to invite you to our homecoming on Saturday, October 29th, is the football game. At 10 in the morning, we're going to be having donuts and coffee, and it'll be a good celebration just to reconnect. And also, in honor of that, we're launching here a Give 20 campaign. So as I mentioned earlier, you can visit mobac.edu/give, and if you can give $20, if you can give $2,000, students, if you can give 20 quarters, I think that would be a good thing, just to join in the celebration and giving to the Society of Fine Arts. It benefits so much of the students' education of what's happening, and we would love you to be a part of that. Also, in the hall, as you leave later tonight, there's a table set up sharing a little bit more about MBU Fine Arts. If you know of a student who should be coming here to study, grab a brochure for them. We also have some postcards out there that tell you more of the events that are coming. Also, on the back of your program, you'll hear a lot more that's out there as well. But on these next couple songs, if we're able to bring the lights up just a little bit, I'll have you join in with those lyrics again in your program, and we'll sing Come Thou Fount and It Is Well.
Thank you.
final song tonight, be reminded, if you've not been encouraged or inspired or motivated yet, leave with the reminder that God sees you, He hears you when you cry out to Him, and He'll make a way. So I want to invite Tara Perry. Tara's been our accompanist now since 2019, and I've also had the great privilege of working with her when I taught high school down in Cape Girardeau, and this is her last official concert with us. So I told the students they had to sing the best concert they've ever done in their lives for Tara. She's just that special. So I want to thank her so much for joining us over these last few years and just doing so much more than playing notes, but joining in the artistry that we participate in together. So this is our closing song. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. We hope that we'll see you at a future concert, event, program, homecoming, and don't forget to give 20.